Rand Paul shouldn't even be on this stage. He's number 11. He's got 1% in the polls, and how he got up here, there's far too many people. Anyway.
His visceral response to attack people on their appearance, short, tall, fat, ugly. My goodness, that happened in junior high. Are we not way above that? Would we not all be worried to have someone like that in charge of the nuclear arsenal?
Mr. Trump.
I never attacked him on his look, and believe me, there's plenty of subject matter right there that I can tell you.
So that did not take long. Rand Paul taking hits almost immediately last night. Just the first of several exchanges between the Kentucky senator and Donald Trump. They've consistently criticized one another on the trail. Senator Rand Paul is my guest now, live today from California. Good morning to you, Senator, and thanks for getting up early. Now,
good morning, Bill. Thanks for having me.
Donald Trump earlier today said that he heard you were going on offense first, and that's why he took the first shot. Is that true?
Well, I think America's about done with him. I think we're about ready to get over and move on. And I sense that in the debate because there was such a silliness and a lack of seriousness on his part that really I think America is going to be done with him. The debate really I think is going to reshuffle the pack. And I think it's the beginning of starting to talk about the real issues. We did have a pretty decent debate on foreign policy last night. You know, for example, Mr. Trump thought it's a good idea to bomb Assad. I think that would have been a bad idea. And had we bombed Assad, I think ISIS would now be in charge of all Syria, including Damascus. So I think really to defeat ISIS, we need to understand that bombing their enemies is not probably a good idea.
Let me come back to that in a moment here. But you said after the debate last night that Donald Trump is on his way down. So before the Twitter war fires
that.
Up,
I think America's
why?
Tired of it. Well, I think the sophomoric sort of jibes. I mean, his insult to Carly Fiorina was just, I think, way over the top. Nobody in America thinks you want some sort of buffoon who insults women and calls them ugly. Nobody wants that. And I think the first time people hear that, some people will laugh at sophomoric jokes. And I think they have for a few months now. But I think the laughing's over. And now it's almost become pitiful. And I think really it's at the point where people are ready to move on. You know, I think talking about, you know, my tax plan, talking about getting rid of the entire tax code and how we'd create jobs. I think people are ready to talk about issues, and I'd replace the whole tax code with one page return. You know, file your tax return on one postcard. And I think these are the kind of things we probably ought to be discussing.
I know you've talked about. Where did this whole thing start with you and Donald Trump?
You know, I think when you strike close to the mark, you can really get somebody going. And I think the fact that I've been calling him a fake conservative, pointing out that he supported Obamacare, pointing out that he supported President Obama's government stimulus plan. And really the one I think that rankles conservatives the most is that he supports taking private property through eminent domain from small property owners and giving it to big corporations. I don't know of one conservative in America who supports that abuse of eminent domain. And so I think as more people hear that, as more people get tired of sort of the diatribes and sophomoric jokes, I think all of a sudden people are going to say, my goodness, it's time to move on. And I think we are there. And I think this is a time now where we can begin to discuss about issues again.